Hi everyone, it is Dena from Miladyleela.com and welcome to my channel. Welcome if you are new and welcome back if you've been here before. I have a really awesome share with you today. And if you've been following me on Instagram, you might have an idea based on the title of this video, what you're going to see today. But first of all, if you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing if you like thrift hauls, because I love going to the thrift. Love, love, love going to the thrift. And I had such a great time over the last 3 days last week. I did a car haul, which you will see prior to this video, of the first trip that I did on a Thursday. I went back on a Friday and I went back on a Saturday. And yeah, and each day back because there was something there that I had left that I kept thinking about. So I just feel like I hit the jackpot. I always say that I don't need any clothes, but I always come home with them. So all that means is that I need to weed some things out of my wardrobe and share them with you all in a wardrobe sale, of which I am planning on putting forth soon. I don't know when, but I will be putting forth a wardrobe sale. So also, you might have noticed in the last couple of videos, I am in a little section of the cottage that you have not yet seen before. This is part of my vintage vanity nook. Behind me is a bookcase that I've filled with all kinds of beauty products and jewelry boxes and things like that. And then what you're seeing right here is kind of a span of some of the items on my vanity. And over here is the clothing rack that separates the room that kind of gives me a little bit of privacy into my vanity area. So, and there's clothes on it right now because I just washed. And for those of you that don't know, I hardly ever dry my clothes. There's certain things and specific things that I dry, but most of the things I hang. So I will just put them on a hanger and hang them up here on the rack and let them dry. And in spring and summer, when the weather is beautiful, I love to hang my laundry outside. There's nothing like hanging laundry outside. But please go ahead and grab your favorite cuppa. Get even a snack because I roll quite long and I think you're going to enjoy this video. So get yourself all prepared. Come on back and let's get into this, shall we? I'm having some water. And when I'm done filming, I'm going to get some more coffee because I really need it. But in this bag, the first bag I'm going to share with you is this beautiful watercolored floral design bag. Actually purchased this at our local grocery store market recently. And I love having bags like this to take to the thrift stores, so, or even to the grocery store, so I don't have to use all the plastic bags that they always give out. Most of the times I forget and I store my things in them just to, you know, stack them before I put them away so I don't have a bunch of bags laying around or before I share it in a video. But I do try to take them to the stores when I go shopping, and I did actually for these thrift hauls. Some of the items, though, had to go in a bag because they didn't all fit in that one. But here we go. I'm going to share with you what I got. So some of the items you might have seen in the car haul, but some of them you have not. Most of them you have not. So I found this beautiful little tank for 99 cents. And by the way, the tickets were pink and white were half off and blue was 99 cents. So this was a white ticket, so it was only 50 cents. Look how cute this is, you guys. This is a marbled style tank top with the pink lace edging and this sweet little rosette right here. Super cute. I love it so much, and it's going to be perfect for layering underneath outfits. Now, this next item that I got, the plan for this, the two next items are, I'm going to deconstruct this piece of clothing. And I talked about that a little bit on a previous Instagram post. I love this beautiful floral cream top. Look how sweet this is with the little tie at the bottom. And I can wear it off the shoulder like this. As you see, I'm wearing, this is a top that I recently thrifted and it has the attached sleeves. I just love this top so much. And it has like the ruching all on the bust line to the waist. And then it has like a skirted peplum kind of bottom. I love it. So this one can be worn off the shoulders as well. And I think it just looks really, really very feminine and soft that way. But what I'm planning on doing is cutting the bottom here and taking the elastic out. And I'll show you why in a moment. I really don't like the silhouette, and I've been using that word a lot, but the silhouette that these types of tops leave on my particular body. I'm short-waisted, so I don't really like that. So I usually cut out the elastic if there is at the bottom. And then I purchased this top, which is adorable in itself. But this one, well, you know what? I'm not even going to go over prices. Let's just say each trip that I did with all of the items that I got was definitely within my budget. And it was just, it was a perfect day. You know, like anything yellow ticket was full price. But for example, at $2.99, you couldn't pass it up. So I purchased this adorable top, which really is sweet by itself. It's very feminine and girly, but I don't particularly like how it is up here. So what I'm planning on doing, and the idea was to purchase the two of them together, I'm going to deconstruct this top as well and take this ruffle off and then attach the ruffle to the bottom of this. And I think that the mixed fabric look, as well as the chiffon and the polka dots in the lace, will look so beautiful with that top. Next, this was also $4.99, but I thought the price was great. And I'm not going to, you know, mention all the prices unless it was full price, but this was $4.99. I thought the price was great because it's in perfect condition and these go for very expensive at the Victoria's Secret store. This is the pink. You know what? I should probably do it this way because if I go the other way, I have my cosmetic brushes out and I need to clean them. And they probably could add makeup residue on these beautiful pieces of clothing. So the sparkly sequins, so cute. I think it's going to look great. It's an all-season top because it is like a really thin cotton. This little hoodie is adorable. I love the color. I love rich wine type of colors, very kind of gothic Victorian looking to me as far as the color combo with the black and the wine. This was half off and it's just a simple, very thin sheer hoodie. And this will match with everything that I just showed you so far. And mainly all of the colors in my wardrobe also. So I just thought it was really cute. And I love that so much. I don't have anything like that as a hoodie in that color. And then I saw, these beautiful stretchy bell-bottom leggings. Excuse me, my nose is a little itchy. And these are in the camo design. They fit super well and they look so good on my body and they are so comfortable. Full price at $3.99, but still can't beat that price. Next, I got this really pretty skirt, and this is a designer named Lauren Conrad. And again, like this is an extra small. You guys, I don't typically wear an extra small. I usually wear a medium, but you can't go by sizes. You have to try things on. You have to eye them up, see if you think that they will fit your body, and then if you think that they will, go ahead and try them on. And if it's without to go into a dressing room, you know, like a jacket or a shirt that you might be able to throw over, or even a skirt, throw over your leggings or whatever you're wearing, that you could do that, then great. You can do that right at the mirror. But sometimes you do need to take things in to the dressing room and get a feel for what it looks like as it would look on your body without all those extra layers. But I love this because this is a long back skirt, but as you can see on either end, it has this gorgeous detail, and I don't have anything like it in my wardrobe right now, currently, that has this detail with the V of the fabric on either side of the leg. I used a skirt that was designed like, and it was striped, and it was really, really cute. But when we moved, I went through my closet and vamped and got rid of that. So it's nice to add something back because I know that that style looks really nice on my body. And as you can see, everything that I've purchased so far are items that will all work well together. This one price, but for $1.99, how can you beat it? And look at this beautiful wine color. As you can see, I love the wine colors. This is just a simple tank top. And this is actually a Victoria's Secret tank. So this is beautiful and it will match, very comfortable, all cotton. It'll match with a lot of my items that I already own. And then I do believe we're getting to some of the things that I've shared before, but I'm going to get to them anyways. Just to reiterate, for those of you that are new, just jumping in on my channel that haven't seen them yet, this is a really cute, this was full price also. For the 3 days that I went shopping, it was the same tickets that were on sale. But this is another one of the tops. It has like the skirted bottom, and it has this V-neck. So I did get a tank top to go underneath it, which I'll show you soon. That's going to be the next piece. I love this detailing right here. You can wear it either in the front or in the back. And the sleeves are amazing because they're long, but they have this cutout right here at the shoulder. So it shows some skin, and it's just really, really very feminine and flattering. And to go underneath it and or to wear with other items, this is pink ticket, so it was half off. I found this adorable tank top in black with the grommet detailing that kind of makes it look a little edgy, and I love it so much. So fabulous. This beautiful scarf, which the detailing on this matches that chiffon blouse that I showed you. But I love this scarf. I'm not sure if I will be using this as a table runner. However, I could, but I will be actually putting it in my wardrobe with my scarf collection because it would make a beautiful handbag bow, or I could wear it, you know, as like a little kerchief if it was a windy day, you know, and I needed to protect my hairstyle if it was in a style that I didn't want to get windblown, or I could even wear it, you know, as a little scarf because I always like to protect my neck. And these are items that just look so elegant inside your handbag too. If you want to add some feminine detail to your handbag, whether you use it as a bow or you place it inside to cover your items so that they can't be seen if, for example, there's no zipper to your bag, or maybe you have a tote and it snaps but you're going to be leaving it open and you don't want everything to be seen, you can just throw a beautiful scarf over top of it, and it just is just so lovely, and it makes it look so beautiful and feminine. Next, I got this. This was also full price, $1.99, so couldn't beat it. This is a pair of little lingerie shorts with the lace at the bottom. And I like wearing these underneath my skirts when I perform because sometimes my skirts are either sheer or short. And I like to make sure that I have something underneath that's not necessarily a slip, because I'm constantly moving around and bending and different things. And, you know, I don't want to show anything. So I like to wear a short kind of style of a slip if you will, underneath. So this is perfect for that. And then these pants, I love these. Jimmy thinks they look like pajama pants. I purchased them thinking they would be great summer pants to wear around the house, out in the yard, and still look really, you know, dressed and not like I was in my jammies, with a cute little pink top of any one of these colors. And, you know, I might still do that for a little while. I have to try these on. I tried them on at the thrift. I did particularly care for looked on my body, and I talked about it in the video, how I kind of felt like they should be a little bit more wider on the inside of my leg, you know, and still have the flare on the outside of my leg. But it seemed like there was too much space, just the way, it's hard to explain, but they just didn't flatteringly fit my body. So what I thought I would do is at some point I would cut the legs off and use the legs as like a beautiful sleeve on another outfit so I could deconstruct it. So no worries if I don't wear it as pants, or if I wear it as pants for a little while and then decide to deconstruct it, not only would I have beautiful sleeves, there would be a lot of extra fabric that I could use. In fact, I might even be able to cut it and make them shorts. So there's a lot of possibilities. They might even look better as a pair of shorts. And then I would still be able to have enough fabric to use as sleeves. Yeah, so there's a lot that I can do with this. And then when I was talking about it in the first video, I didn't even realize that I might be able to use it as shorts and have it look better. So I have to try it on again and see what that looks like. And then the last piece of clothing in this particular bag is this adorable little tutu, which was $2.99 from the children's section. I've talked about my tips and tricks from shopping in the children's section, and you know, you might find something there if you like wear, if you're a petite person and you wear like a smaller or medium, you might be able to get away with like the extra large little girl or the girl's clothing. And I do that a lot. So I always check. Some things are a little bit too little girlish. And some of you in, you know, some of you might think that this is too much of little girlish look. But what I like to do with these, this is actually much too short to even wear on stage. Much too short. What my plan is for this, and what I like to do with skirts that are this short, is, as you can see, the tulle lace is beautiful. So I like to wear it with like a tank top or another shirt or a blouse over top that's not exactly the length that I like my shirts or blouses to be. This gives it the additional length, and it creates another layer. And then it kind of holds, as I was mentioning, it kind of hides, you know, where you harvest maybe some belly fat or something like that. And it just, you know, I'm a poet and I didn't even know it. It just kind of adds a little bit of layering, but in a beautiful silhouette, so that, you know, you just look more flattering in your clothing rather than putting on a pair of pants and having maybe a little bit of a belly that you're working on trimming and it just doesn't look right. Well, things like this underneath certain shirts, it depends on the shirt. I mean, you just have to try things on and play around with your clothes, play dress up and see what's going to work best, but it really gives a nice little added layer. And then I did get two belts, and I wore one of these already, and I actually posted a picture on Instagram where I talked about going to the thrift on my 3-day spree and being able to deconstruct certain things. But I love this belt. They had two of these belts. I'm always on the lookout for little belts like this that I could wear around the waist just for added layer and detail. And I got this in brown, and then they had the exact one in the same size in black. So black with the silver and brown with the gold. And I had mentioned, depending on the handbags that you might own, you could actually play around with these and use them as an added strap to your handbags. So I love these belts. I'm very pleased with that purchase. Then I also picked up a couple of little toys. These are super cute. This one was half off, and I got this for Jimmy. I will be including this. I didn't even notice this until just now. I will be including this in a gift for him. I'm not exactly sure if I'm going to hold it for his birthday or give it to him before. But it says, and I did not notice this, the Hard Rock Cafe Pittsburgh, and our band actually played at the Hard Rock Cafe in Pittsburgh. And even more special about it is that this little guy is blue, and that the video that was taken that night of our performance, the lights on stage were blue, and they gave the most beautiful, eerie, mysterious glow to the band. So this is actually a perfect little gift, and I can't wait to give that to him. And then I got this one for myself. I couldn't pass her up. I just thought she was super cute. And hang on one second. I'm just trying to clean her up a little bit. Okay. This little girl right here, she was $1.99. I saw her the one day and I left her behind, and she was there the very next day. And I thought when I went back, if she is there, I'm going to pick her up and bring her home with me. And I just think she is so cute. She's a little kitty cat, and she's all spotted in pastel colors with the beautiful pink eyes. I just love her. She's darling. And then I got two handbags. So I think I got this one the very next day, so you haven't seen this one yet. And this was originally $5.99, but I got it for 99 cents. I love this bag. I don't have anything like it. At first, when I saw it, I thought, oh, it's really not my style. And even though it's 99 cents, I'm just going to leave it behind. Somebody else might love it more. But I thought about it, and it was there the next day, and I love the gold chain. You know, I just love that. I love the gold, and I love the fact that you can actually hold it just like this as a little clutch. It fits your hand perfect, and it opens up like this, and it's so new inside, like it was never, ever, ever used. And it doesn't have a lot of room, so basically you could put your cell phone in here, maybe a little card case, and probably like a small mirror and a lipstick. But I think it's really cool, and I have a collection of vintage handbags, and I've never seen anything like this, so I thought, this is super cool. Like, I could use this so many different ways on so many different occasions, like for a date night, or, you know, if we were, like, a performance, I could take it if I wanted to. I typically wouldn't use this for performance, but if I was going to see somebody else's band for a date night, I could grab this. We've done, like, movie date nights before where I've used some of my vintage handbags instead of my regular handbag because they're smaller, and when you sit in a movie theater, you don't have a lot of room. So, you know, just things like that. And this is just so freaking unique. I love it. Speaking of handbags, I also got this one, which is perfect for the spring and summer. Look at this adorable, beautiful little pink clutch. And this one was never worn either. This one was half off, and it's perfect inside. And this is the attached little crossbody. I probably wouldn't use this. More than likely, I would just tuck it in. And it just opens up right here on the hinges. And there's a small little zipper pouch here that you could put something inside. And it's just the perfect little clutch for running out to the store for a date night, even a little bag in bag kind of thing. Like, I like to do tote bags a lot. And then I will prepare a smaller handbag so I can just grab and go if I'm going into a store. Most of the time I just grab my little card case and I run into the store, but you know, sometimes you like to have a bag so you can, you know, if you don't have a pocket, you can put your cell phone in the bag and your keys and your phone, your keys, and your card case in a small bag. Could also be used for cosmetics, although I probably wouldn't because I wouldn't want the inside to get all dirty. It's not necessarily one that would be wipeable, but I think that it would be a sweet little date night bag, or also, like I said, a, you know, a bag within a bag kind of thing. And then I did get 3 VHS tapes. This one, I wasn't sure if I had it home. And when I got it home, I did discover that I already own this. So I am probably going to put this one up for sale. And, you know, I do usually my sales via YouTube. So I will probably have this up for sale in like a YouTube home decor kind of sale. So anyways, this is the Peter Rabbit. And it is the tale of Peter Rabbit and Benjamin Bunny, Beatrix Potter. And I love it so much. I can't wait to get my VHS player set up. I need help with that from Jimmy. But I have Alice in Wonderland with Johnny Depp, but I don't have the Disney. And this is the Gold Collection Classic, Alice in Wonderland. So I'm super excited about this one. You know, I always open up to look at the tapes. They look like they're in good shape. So I have that now to add to my collection. And then this one is a family classic. And this is the WB. So that's, what is that? Warner Brothers, maybe? Is WB Warner Brothers? I should know. Yeah. Yeah. This is Black Beauty. And I am super excited about this. This is going to be just a very special, special movie. I can't wait to watch it. So, you know, because it's like, it's just a classic. The most imaginative and stirring picture since The Black Stallion. And that was posted on there from a long time ago, because this is a very old, old movie from copyright 1994. It says Black Beauty has been one of the world's, okay, but this was, okay, this was published even before that. Yes. Black Beauty has been one of the world's most beloved animal stories since it's first published in 1877. The story is told by its hero, a remarkable black horse with a white star on his forehead, whose joyous and heartbreaking life takes him from idyllic days on a country squire's estate to London's hard cobblestone streets. This most faithful movie version of Anna Sewell's novel, written and directed by Caroline Thompson, The Secret Garden, Homeward Bound, and The Incredible Journey, brings to vivid life the book of characters as never before. You'll cherish the rebellious Lily Ginger, the mischievous pony Merrylegs, and the gallant beauty whose generous heart guides him through decades of owners and caretakers, both kindly and harsh. Front Farmer Gray and young groom Joe Green, who was Andrew Scott Knott of The Secret Garden, which I love The Secret Garden, to sweet-natured cabby Jerry Barker. Most importantly, the love for all creatures, great and small, infuses every scene. Getting emotional. This is what gives Black Beauty its enduring magic and makes this a radiant, heartfelt delight. I cannot wait to watch this. Oh my gosh. I need a tearjerker, you guys. I really do. I need to release. So, one more thing in this bag, and that is this beautiful orange candle that I did not get to use as a candle the way it is standing at the moment. I got this candle. It was brand new, and it was originally from Target, and I got it for 99 cents. So at Target, it was probably, I don't see a price on it. It was probably over $10. And they had it listed for $5.99, and I got it for 99 cents because it was blue ticket. So what I'm planning on doing with this is I'm going to burn her down, melt her down, and create new candles and wax melts with her. And I'm thinking about adding like cinnamon oil and things like that, and creating them for the fall, for gift giving season, for the holiday season. So I'm excited about that. I think that's really lovely. And that is a little tip and technique. Look for candles that you can repurpose and burn down to make new items. All right. Bear with me, guys. I'm just putting it all back. You know how I roll. Before I can move on to the next bag. I got a lot of washing ahead of me. You know, I think that they do a really nice job at the Salvation Army about keeping things clean. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned, all of this is from the Salvation Army. And I really like the Salvation Army a lot. I actually like it better than Goodwill. But Goodwill has better bargains, I think, on like home decor kind of items, just in general. But this one in particular, thrift store Salvation Army, is so clean and color-coded, and I just love it. All right, so the next shopping was this. So I went back for this because I had seen this, and I didn't get it because it was running late. We had a gig that night on a Saturday. So like I said, I went Thursday. No, we had a gig on a Friday. I went Thursday, Friday, and then I went Saturday. So I spotted this on Friday, and I didn't see it on Thursday. I spotted it on Friday, but I had a gig that night, so I had to leave. I didn't have time to try it on. Went back again on Saturday, and it was exactly where it was, where I left it, and I bought it. And I love it. It looks cute by itself, and it also looks cute layered over something because I put it over what I was wearing. And this is an Abercrombie and Fitch item. So it's very good quality. It is a satin tank top with these adorable little button features. And then it has a tie on the bottom, which when I saw it at the shop, the tie was tied. But I untied it just to see how much of a leverage I had in creating the bottom bow. And I just absolutely adore this. And it will go with so many things. And speaking of one of them that it will go with, I saw this 2 days in a row that I was there. And it was still there on the third day. And, you know, I didn't get it the first 2 days. It was like I saw it, but I wasn't really that interested. I kind of passed it by. But when I was there on that Saturday, and I saw it, I was like, wow, that is so lovely, and it will match. It kind of matched with what I was wearing that day, first of all. I had on a pair of leopard leggings and like a really nice top that I also thrifted that's like two-toned with like a beige and a camel coloring. And then I wore that belt with the brown and the gold, and I had on black boots. So I put this skirt on. It was one of those things where I tried it on outside of the, I didn't try it on outside of the dressing room. I did go into the dressing room because I wanted to try on the tank top, but I put this on over top of my leggings at first, and it looked so cute with a bit of a different pattern of leopard leggings poking out from the bottom. So I thought, amazing. This could be worn all year round. Excuse me. It could be worn all year round. In the wintertime, I love wearing dresses, but it's so cold sometimes, dresses and skirts. So I like to layer, and I could wear this. Oops, I just dropped my cap. I could wear this with my leggings if I wanted to. And I have other leggings that it would match as well. So it is this adorable peasant leopard skirt. Oh my gosh, you guys. And it is lined, as you can see right here, is the inside of the lining. It has a lined slip. And it's just so, all of these ruffled layers. And then this little feature right here of the tie. Oh my gosh. It is so me. I love it. It's so me for so many reasons. First of all, it's so gypsy style with the ruffles and the peasant look of it. And, you know, just really like a relaxed kind of look. You know, I admire, I'm getting off the subject for a minute, but, you know, I admire some of those girls and ladies that have like the perfect pin straight hair, and they can wear like really nice, like tweed suits and like, and even like, you know, designer kind of suits, and they look so good in them. And I'm not saying that I don't look good in them, but when I wear them, when I wear them, and it sounds like I'm tooting my own horn, I'm going to say it looks cool. It looks like a vibe. When they wear them, it looks like that's where they belong. Like it looks good on them, right? And so when I say that my style is more gypsy and more relaxed, seriously, guys, can you see this hair? Would you consider this to be relaxed? No. Right now, my hair, I need to wash it and condition it. It's been a few, you know, days, and it's just really like just from brushing it out with my hands, you know, it's like got the frizz, and it's just, you know, it's like some of you might think it looks really cute, but to me, like, look, I've got like this curl thing going on here, and then the rest is like this just mess. So yeah, my hair, even when it's straightened professionally, and I don't get it straightened professionally, like long term. It's just, you know, like a blowout professional styling of straightening it. It's still like is not my thing or my personality to look like that belongs as far as that kind of dressing and style. The dressing and style for me is definitely like this kind of thing of putting things together and mismatching items that yet work together, and peasant kind of skirts, and, you know, not that I don't clean up well when I have to get dressed up in a certain outfit for a show or anything, like, you know, or a wedding or something like that. But even when I get dressed up to do a performance, it's usually a very different kind of like gypsy kind of style. If you know what I'm talking about, if you know, you know. So this is like so perfect for me. And I just talked way too much about that. Sorry. Okay. And next, speaking of that, oh my God, speaking of that style, this to me, I caught this out of the corner of my eye, and I'm so glad that I did. It was not on sale. It was $5, and I paid the $5, which is still a good price. This is actually meant to be a skirt. So it's too crazy, too like young, if you will, for me to wear it as a skirt with a blouse by itself. But it could be worn as one of those skirts that I use as layering underneath a blouse with a pair of leggings or something like that. Or it could be worn as a top. And then, of course, you would see my bra straps, you know, like I always wear a bra. I have to wear a bra. So, you know, and I still think that this looks nice. That's my opinion. You might not think so, but my opinion is I like this look of the strap showing. It's, you know, like I have a little tank underneath or something, even though it is my bra. So I would do the same thing with this, and or I could put removable little straps on it. And I say removable because then that way I have the option to wear it either as a shirt or as a skirt. And this just looks like a Victorian manners curtain. Are you ready? This is the brand Wild Fable. Look at this, you guys. This is so fabulous. And I did not try it on. So I'm not even sure if I'm going to be able to work it in what I'm envisioning it to be in either way, either as a top or as a bottom, you know, but this style is so cute. And the way it's done, I could even cut the seam up, make it a valance, and I would use it more than likely, because there's only one, and I have two windows in this room, so that wouldn't work. But I would probably use it whenever I do my trunk shows and I decorate my space. I would use it as a valance of some sort, either to line my table or as a valance up top behind my table. So I had to get this piece, and it's velvet, purple velvet. It's so beautiful. Oh my gosh. All right. And then lastly from this, oh no, two other things, two things. I saw this piece, which I couldn't pass up because they don't make things like this anymore in this pattern. And this was $1.99, and it is a beautiful, it's actually made to be a relish dish. You know, where you would place like olives and maybe some cheeses and do like a small little offering on your supper table if you were having company. I'm probably not going to use it for that, but I might. A lot of my antique pieces and thrifted pieces, I interchange a lot. So I might use it for jewelry on my vanity or for nail polish or something like that. It might be found in my kitchen as a spoon rest one day. Nevertheless, it could be used for so many different things. So I absolutely adore this. And I had to get it. I just thought it was a really cool pattern. And then lastly from that trip, I had spied this, and there was two of these items on all 3 days that I went shopping. I had spotted this. On the first day, which was a Thursday, there was two of them. When I went back on Friday, there was only one. And when I went back on Saturday, it was still there, and there was only the one left, obviously. So it was $5.99. I did pay full price for it, but there's something about this piece that just evokes such peace for me. It is a beautiful nature scene with a lake and a cabin cottage and birch trees, of which I love. And the frame is gold. And both of the items, I had one in my cart on Thursday and then I put it back. Both of the pieces were relatively okay, you know, as far as the frame, in the same manner. Like one wasn't beat up more than the other per se. So when I saw that there was still one left, I got it because I knew it would be gone. And I don't know that I will always use it as a picture. I may not, because I really don't have anywhere to put it. This is like a fall scene, and I could hang it up, and I might, but my initial idea for this was to use it as a tray on our bar. But look how beautiful this piece is. It just is gorgeous. So there's like this wooden cottage and the birch trees in the forefront and the beautiful foliage of fall and the lake. I just, with the sun, it's like the golden hour. It's so gorgeous. So I may hang this up here in the wardrobe. I have one space that I might decide to put it, but I'm not sure. So we'll see about that, but it is really beautiful and I couldn't pass it up. I had to get it since it was still there, and it made so much sense to get it, because I knew that it wouldn't be there the next time. And then one last item from the thrift. My bending over. Sorry about that, you guys. One last item. Okay, so on Thursday, I spotted this. I thought about it all Thursday night. I could not sleep. I went back on Friday to get it, and it was there. And I was so delighted to see it on the shelf. And I paid full price. It was $5. But it is a vintage lampshade. And if you've watched my channel, you know that I've talked about the beautiful vintage rose vase lamp that I have in my kitchen. And I'm currently using a lampshade on it that's beaded, that I actually found while walking with my cats. We take our cats for a walk. And I was walking with my cat, one cat at the time. And it was like garbage day on our street. And somebody was throwing out a lamp. And so I got the lamp. The lamp cord had been cut, so I either had to replace the cording to use it as a lamp or take it apart and use the pieces for other things. So I chose to use the pieces for other things. I made a portion of the lamp, a little pen and pencil holder on my desk in the magical kitchen creativity corner. And then there was a little ball part that was like a hobnail in crystal that I haven't done anything yet with. And then, of course, the lampshade. But when I saw this, this one will go actually so much better. And if for whatever reason it doesn't work, it's one of those things that will work here in the wardrobe. I could hang it from the ceiling and have like a, either a light in it or just hang it as decoration. It's so amazing. Get ready. I have never seen anything like this. The color is so unique. It's like a vintage gold with black beads and white pearls and gold rickrack. It is so gorgeous, and it's all pleated, and it is in perfect, perfect condition. Not even a touch of staining. I mean, it is just, it's incredible. So all I need to do is look for a finial to put up here. And I'm thinking about, because the lamp in the creativity corner is has gold accents, I'm thinking about using some rub and buff that I have in my antique gold color and making this gold. But like I said, this would be perfect here in the wardrobe. And if it doesn't work for that lamp, I know exactly where I'm going to put this. Usually, and you guys might even know, usually when I'm filming, I am actually on the other side of where I'm sitting now, and I'm sitting on my, I would sit on my love seat, and behind me are two clothing racks and my ancestor wall of my grandparents and my parents. And yeah, and then my vintage perfume bottles that I've collected and my mill collected. And I could envision this hanging from the ceiling, like right over that section. Oh my gosh. It wouldn't even need a lamp in it. You know how you see those things in like really posh stores where they have like all these unique things just hanging from the ceiling that are just beautiful to look at, you know, just, oh gosh. So yeah, there's so much I can do with this. So I can't wait to see if it's going to work on that lamp. And if not, like I said, no worries. It will definitely fit inside here. And that, my friends, is it. Now, I don't know, speaking of lampshades, if I mentioned on Facebook Marketplace, my daughter, Nicole, had found a beautiful crystal candelabra chandelier for me. And it was free on Facebook Marketplace. And it had five arms, and it came with five little lampshades. And the lampshades were not necessarily in the best of shape, but I decided that I was going to use it as a chandelier without the lampshades. So the best lampshade shade that I could find, I did take off, and I use now in the magical kitchen, because I have a little lamp there by the fridge and it needed a sweet little lampshade. So it works out perfect in there. And the other ones I'll probably just fix up. I might have to paint, and you know, I can use them at another time. But in the meantime, the chandelier is going to be placed here in the wardrobe. I currently have a ceiling fan, but it's been here for so many years. It has a light on it as well. And the light works, but the ceiling fan motor quit working. And yes, I could repair it. It does get kind of warm in here. But I think that a chandelier, we don't have whole house air conditioning. I think I would rather set a fan up on my table and have the fan on me when I'm in this room, because I'm not in this room like for many, many hours or anything like that. I would rather than have a new ceiling fan. I would rather have that chandelier in here. So I'm hoping that that's going to work. It looks like all of the parts are going to be okay, and that the wiring is okay. And even if the wiring would need replaced, Jimmy knows how to do some rewiring. So I might be able to make that work. If not, then I'm just going to disassemble the chandelier and just use the crystals in some of my art projects. But in the meantime, I'm thinking that the chandelier would be beautiful in here. So yeah, I would have a chandelier and that beautiful lampshade if it doesn't work where I'm hoping to put it. Anyhow, with all of that being said, you guys, I love you all so much. I hope that you enjoyed this shopping spree. I did also go to Big Lots and Dollar Tree and get some things. I will probably be doing an upcoming video on that just to show you some of the items that I purchased there that are Bath & Body kind of items from Big Lots. I think Dollar Tree was just like random stuff. So I don't know. I might incorporate that in with the Big Lots haul since it's like not a whole lot. But yeah, I'd like to share with you. I know it seems like I do a lot of hauls and shopping things, but I like to share with you the items that I get because I like to sprinkle in little tips and techniques along the way of things that you can do or utilize for future knowledge. So I hope that you enjoyed this. If you did, please give this video the thumbs up. It lets me know that you did enjoy. Subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell as well so you don't miss a single post every time I upload. Please do drop me a comment in the comments section below because you know I love to talk to you. And with all of that being said, I wish you so much love, many, many blessings, many friendships to come. I appreciate all of you and all of your time wherever you are in the world for watching me and following me in this beautiful but mad crazy world that we live in. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.